Put on your shields.
It's about to get science in here. Okay, so the audio is going to sound like crap if I leave this thing on the whole time. So we're not going to do that, I promise. But that is an important component. Give me just a second to get ready here. Gotta put the stereotypical headphones on. Of course, Sennheiser brand, hashtag not sponsored. This is a very important tool if you're working on resin 3D printers. You don't need one, but I highly recommend a face shield. Face shields are very useful. They'll keep splashes from getting on you and are great if you wear actual eyeglasses and you don't want to put a pair of safety glasses over it. These are more expensive than safety glasses, but they protect your whole face, your chin, and even from resin splashing up and then dripping down. It's not going to keep it out of your hair. But I mean, that's a lot easier than keeping it off your face. So we like these. They're also ballistic rated. Not that you should have issues with that for resin printing. But resin printing is dangerous. And it's a subject that a few creators have talked about, but I don't think anybody's talked about it enough. I don't think we can stress safety enough here on 3D Musketeers because we don't want you having a bad experience because of a lack of safety protocol. And I'm not saying to go out, get yourself a bunny suit and supplementary air and all of that. No, I'm saying there are some precautions that we can take to ensure as best as possible that you can remain safe when working on resin. And a face shield is a great way to do that. This is mine. It is a Uvex brand. It's actually made by Honeywell, I believe. And does come with full ANSI certification on it. Again, not that that's entirely important for this thing, but yes, this is made by Honeywell. And when I bought it at the time, it was like 20 bucks on Amazon. We'll have links in the description to it and a couple of other choices, but it is my preference because resin can splash. And the last thing that we want is resin on our faces. But Grant, how are we gonna protect our eyes? Well, if you don't want to wear one of these, and I get it, they don't look all that nice, and yeah, they don't look great, and it certainly doesn't sound great for audio either,
but it beats having resin in your face. That's all I'm saying. And these are easy to clean, and the shields are actually replaceable. So, but you can get safety glasses. I would recommend the ones that are full wraparound. We'll have links to those in the description as well. Links to everything that I'm talking about will be in the description down below so that if you are looking to pick up kind of a everyday resin kit, you can get that. So minimally safety glasses, the nice wraparound ones as well so resin can't splash up and hit you. But this isn't like going to SeaWorld and having Shamu hit you right on the front row, if you know what I'm saying, because you dropped the build plate or something into the vat and it splashed back at you. That's really what it's from. It's not because the process sprays resin everywhere. That's not how it works. Gloves are the other thing that you need to look at, objectively speaking. Gloves have gone up crazy, crazy high in price. I remember going to Harbor Freight, going to Sam's Club and getting 100 gloves for $8. But looking at it now, they're way more expensive. I think 100 gloves is running like 18 bucks from Harbor Freight and upwards of $25 on Amazon. And that kind of sucks. Keep an eye on your big box retailers like Sam's Club, Costco, or any of the warehouse style retailers in your area. That's gonna be the best place to get gloves from. But until then, the yellow gloves from the dollar store will work great because unlike nitrile gloves, they're reusable. Nitrile gloves, technically you can reuse, but they're very thin. And if you've ever put on nitrile gloves the wrong way, they tear really easily. And these yellow gloves from the dollar store don't. But do not wash uncured resin off of the gloves. Make sure before you take your gloves off that you put them under a UV light or literally have someone open a door for you so you can go out into the sun and do that. So the gloves are cured. You don't want raw resin going down your drain and potentially poisoning a water supply. Now, yes, it would take a lot of it, but don't be that guy or gal. Don't be that person. Once the resin is cured, you should just be able to move the gloves and it just kind of flakes off. So what we recommend is you have a trash can without a lid. Ours is actually right here. I didn't do a good job of hiding it this time, but oh well. You can just like move your gloves and the raw and the not the raw resin, but the cured resin falls off into the trash can for reasonably safe disposal. There is no good way of recycling cured UV resin. I'm sorry, that's just the way that it goes. Do understand that if you get raw resin on your skin or clothes, it needs to be washed off immediately. You must realistically stop what you're doing and go get it taken care of. Some people will be highly allergic to this chemical, this 3D resin. If I can find some SDSs, I'll put them in the description for you. But needless to say, it is toxic to humans. It is toxic to animals. You should not handle it and don't drink it. Resin is something that we shouldn't mess around with. And while there are low VOC resin, and VOC is volatile organic compound, so that's what things smell like. If you've ever painted a house with the wrong paint, you know exactly what I'm talking about, but they say paint is low VOC, but even when you're painting, you're like, there's a smell. Resin is the same way, but the resin smell from non-low VOC resin is bad. If you have the availability to vent your printer, put it in a room with ventilation, or put it into like a garage or a shed, do that. In our office, we have two VOC filters that enable us to run resin with people without being able to smell it. Because if you can't smell it, you're generally going to be okay. So we have VOC and we have HEPA inside of this office that ensures that we are breathing as clean air as we possibly can, as well as ultraviolet stuff. But we had that before COVID. It's just something you got to be aware of. So if you have a bathroom that you don't use, that's a great place for a resin printer. Although kind of weird for guests, just let them know, hey, there's this weird thing in there, you know, or just remove it for guests. Remove it for guests, okay? Don't let them touch it. They might think it's like hand soap or something. Don't do that. But a bathroom is great because they generally have vents to atmosphere that can help move away those volatile organic compounds. The other thing is the work surface. If you do not protect your work surface, it will get ruined. We use cheap plywood because it's easiest for us. Since we have so many resin printers, we can just protect the surface all at once. And then every, you know, once a year, maybe twice a year, go ahead and replace that wood and clean the printers while we are at it. Because a clean workspace is a healthy one. We've seen people use the cheap cookie sheets from the dollar store as work surface protectors. And you know what? Those work great. Because even if you puncture your vat and lose all of the resin all over your work surface, the large rounded edges of a cookie sheet should retain it while you facepalm, making sure that you're not only protecting your work surface, but protecting it from others that aren't trained to use it is also important. Inquisitive pets, especially cats, can be susceptible to being poisoned by this chemical. Thankfully, our director of marketing has no interest in resin printing whatsoever, any interest in any of the 3D printers, because she grew up around them and they were just always there. It's not something new and weird for her to look at and sniff. It's just something that she's always had. You can train your pets to not deal around the machines, and I recommend that that is something you do. You don't want to pay for an emergency vet bill. It will likely cost you more than your printer. So don't be an idiot. Protect the ones you love. And that includes both humans and non-humans. Protecting your skin, your vision, your clothing is very important. If you want to wear a shop apron, we recommend that if you want to be able to protect your clothes. But what we do instead is we just wear a crappy set of clothes when we're working on resin. If for some reason it gets on the clothes, we'll quickly take off whatever it is, put it outside to cure in the sun, change into a different shirt, and in 20, 30 minutes, it's fine. Now we do wash everything after it's been cured in very hot water to make sure that everything that could be in it has been removed. But making sure that you cure the clothing minimally and wash it before you put it back on, you'll be fine. Just understand, it will stain your clothing. We're going to link to a photo. We were going to put it in this video, but when I saw it again, I realized it is absolutely not safe for work. It is an individual who was carrying a resin printer during a car ride and it spilled all on their thigh. Their skin got blisters from the chemical burns that occurred from the resin soaking into their shorts and them not realizing the dangers. I'm not saying this to scare you. Again, click on it at your own risk. I'm not your guardian, so, you know, you've been warned. But it's something for you to understand that this is a possibility. And taking those proper precautions will enable you to be safe. Because safety is a concern of ours. And that's why we use actual face shields. We use minimally elbow length gloves, because even if you're wearing a short sleeve shirt, generally speaking, everything should be covered at that point. We want to reduce risk. We have VOC filters. You don't need to go that far because they are incredibly expensive, but just make sure the printers are not near where people will be trafficking the area very often, and you should be okay. It's simple. Don't be an idiot. Take basic safety precautions and you'll be fine. One other thing to note, watch out for that scraper. If you've been in this industry long enough, you've likely stabbed yourself with one of the sharpened paint scrapers that we all used to get parts off. If you happen to stab yourself with resin through your glove, you're gonna have an adverse reaction. This happened to me a couple of weeks ago, and I got kind of sick from it because my body was reacting to an unknown chemical in its bloodstream. Now, the contents were clearly very low, but there was an adverse side effect. And it was one of those things of going to the maker group saying, hey, this just happened, what should I do? And we all kind of collectively decided that it's not a poison control thing as long as we monitor the symptoms and verify. I got a little sick, threw up once, and that was it. But you gotta be careful. Now on my not scraping hand, I wear a cutting glove as well. Those are expensive. And I'm debating on putting it under the actual gloves that we use. Haven't really gotten to that point yet, but just be careful. There are some really cool flexible build plate systems available, and we're going to review those here pretty soon, especially for the Elegoo Saturn and some of these larger resin 3D printers, that your prints can be so big that the suction force between the print and the build plate is high enough that when it comes off, you're hitting it really hard and is likely to just scrape right into your hand. So be careful, everybody. That's why wash and cure stations exist. By the way, if you want to see us review one of the newest, largest wash and cure stations, get subscribed because you got that video coming. The box was just delivered yesterday and we're going to do an unboxing here shortly. I'm excited to show you all this big freaking wash and cure station. But there's a lot to it. If you see water washable resin, do not wash it in the sink. We're gonna have a whole video going over the materials as well, so get subscribed if you want to see that. But in the comments below, let us know if you're going to get a resin printer, and if you are, what safety precautions are you going to take? And let's have an honest conversation about it, because you might say, you know, I'm just gonna go with regular safety glasses. I've worked with two-part epoxy resin before. I know what I'm doing. Or, hey, I'm just gonna get a flexible build plate so I can just peel it off the build plate, throw it into my wash and cure station and be done. We're gonna talk all about, in an upcoming video, how to clean your resin parts and what chemicals that we use that we have found effective. But I hope this video hasn't scared you. The goal is to not scare you, it's to educate you. Because you can do this, you can use resin 3D printers, because they're really not all that crazy. And if you don't believe me, we're gonna have a card right here so you can go take a look at the inside of a resin 3D printer. They're really, really simple. There's no reason to be afraid of them. So stay safe out there, don't forget to call your loved ones, and as always, keep making awesome. My name's Grant, and we're buckled up for safety. Have a good one. It is toxic to humans, it is toxic to animals. You should not handle it. And even though it looks like a milkshake, the only boys it's gonna bring to your yard is poison control. So don't drink it. It's also very expensive. That'd be the most expensive milkshake most of us have ever had. And it doesn't taste great. Okay, I don't know if it doesn't taste great. I imagine it doesn't taste great. We can remove this.